Hey guys, James here today, and welcome to Showcase number 2. This is where we go through some awesome lots that I've picked out from the sharing system on my site. And I've picked out, again, another 15 that we're going to go through and have a look at. And again, this is only a few lots out of many. There are now over 1,000 lots that have been shared on my site, and that is a crazy number. And of course, I can't pick all of them in one go because that would be ridiculous. So basically, what I've sort of narrowed myself down to is doing 15 per showcase, and showcases will probably range from 1 to 2 weeks apart, and we'll go from there. And of course, you can continue submitting lots as long as you like, and yeah. So we're going to start off and get straight into it. All right, here we are on the first lot, Sorry Paradise by 6MC2C-EAPAL-CCQA. Looks almost like their CD key code that they've just put as their username. It's not, but it's an interesting username. Anyways, yeah, so this is obviously a resort that they have built. I don't believe it was actually built in a Lunar Island. It looks like from the pictures they posted anyways, it was built for Island Paradise, but they submitted it. And all the same, it does fit in a Lunar Island just fine, and it's pretty damn sweet. So it's a nice big resort here. Lots of rooms here. You can see there's quite a few up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pretty much the same sort of unit there. Seven rooms by the looks of it. Yeah, that looks about it. A couple car parking spots. Nice gym down over here. Reception area is looking pretty fancy. Nice, like, seats there. Nice large dining area. Plenty of buffet tables through here. What have we got in here? A little massage area. That's pretty cool. A couple of saunas as well. Lots of elevators to get up and down between the floors. A bar area as well. Live music. And a bloody great pool as well. Like, look at that. It's pretty damn sweet. Lots of fountains over there. I love that, actually. I have seen that in real life around the place where you just have, like, this sort of center area where they have, like, fountains going above it, which is pretty cool. They have forgotten to paint that, though, which is kind of a bit of a shame. But anyways, yeah, really cool resort. That's kind of all I wanted to show you about it, because that's what it is. And you can now put it in your worlds. Your Sims can go on a little vacation now as well. I kind of wish that resorts worked between worlds, so you could travel to another world to go to a resort, not that you had to live in the world to go to the resort. It's kind of weird in a way that if you live in the world, it's like, well, this is a tiny island. If you lived here, why would you pay to go to this resort? It doesn't make any sense. But anyways, you could obviously own the resort and run it that way to get a bit of extra money. All right, let's move on to the next one then. Here we are on lot number 9. This is Three Side View by Niram. I don't know. I can usernames. What can I do? Anyways, I thought this one was actually really cool. It's called Three Side. Obviously, there's 1, 2, 3. I thought this was actually a really cool idea. It just looked really awesome. Have all these sort of cantilevered buildings coming out of the cliff in all different ways. I think it's really awesome. Also, they've utilized a sort of beach area down the bottom as well, which is really cool. So anyways, let's jump around to the front and see what's going on here. So we've got this kind of cool green ribbon going through it, which is pretty awesome as well. Let's have a look at the main building. So when you come in, you obviously come into the sort of main foyer area where we have these double wide staircases and a nice diagonal kitchen area. Looking pretty nice. A nice home gym, of course, with a TV on the wall. A large sitting area that is, oh no, it's still there. I was going to say it's out over the cliff, but it is not yet. Then a dining room or dining area, which in reality is quite far away from the kitchen. It's quite a walk to dine, but anyways, I think it's worth the views. And then right down at the end here, we have an outdoor sitting / dining / barbecue area, which I think would be insanely awesome to have in real life. Imagine having this in real life. You're out over the cliff. There's nothing below you, and you've just got this infinite view across the ocean. That would be insanely sick. Like, that would be so cool to have in real life. Anyways, the second level of this building, we move up. Obviously, we have all the bedrooms. Have a little DJ booth here as well, which is kind of cool. So we've got the large sort of master bedroom here. Plenty of room around there. Little desk as well. And an ensuite, of course. A little reading area in the middle there with a futuristic easel. This is kind of like a future house. But I feel like it can easily pass for just a modern house. It's not specifically futuristic. I don't know. Maybe that's not the master suite, because this looks like the master bedroom as well. Although this one seems to have much less privacy in terms of the ensuite bathroom and all that. But, you know, that's just how it rolls. A large two-story sort of area here. I guess that'd be pretty sweet. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Sorry about that. I've ruined your windows. So they've got this, like, sort of two-story high windows here, so you get this beautiful view out there, out through the house, straight out to the ocean. And that's obviously the roof there. Over in this other little building, what do we have over here? We have a nice pool table. So it's like an entertaining area. Pool table, little lounge, and a sort of bar area there as well. Nice area for entertaining. Now, this area in the middle here I thought was really cool as well. It's just the stairs. That's all it is. But it's really nicely done. It's got this cool wall going around there, and it's nice sort of snaking down the cliffside here. Lots of shrubbery, lots of greenery there as well. Looking really awesome. Now, this, again, I thought was really interesting. They have, like, I mean, I don't know how this would work in reality, because that would probably be super, super heavy with all that water there. And it would probably, I don't know. It could work, but that'd be very, very heavy in terms of water weight. But it's a really cool pool area there. Sort of windows going out to the ocean and a nice big view off the side there as well. Suspended over the beach area down the bottom here, where you have a nice sitting area, another sitting area, and a place to park your boats. And I think it's just a really cool lot overall. Really cool design. Something very, very different to what we've seen before. And I think it's pretty damn awesome. All right, now we've just jumped next door to the lot you were probably looking at before. Anyways, this one is called Luna Precipice, but I presume it's supposed to be Precipice because Precipice isn't a word and Precipice is, which also means just like steep cliff. So a little bit of a typo in the title, but we'll forgive you because it's an awesome lot nonetheless. This is obviously by Jesse Hu, as you can see on the screen now. So it's just a cool kind of lot. It's pretty inconspicuous from the street here. So it's just this big sort of angled area there. Sort of a sunken garage, inconspicuous entrance, and then we get to the real business area of the lot. Anyways, let's have a look inside, shall we? So over on this part here, we've got this sort of outdoor area. This is like just a sort of a walkway to get to the main house. Lots of shrubbery, nice barbecue area out the back here. Lots of privacy with a nice big fence. And so it sort of blocks off the peering neighbors, especially from all the kids in the school. I mean, the kids in the classroom could look over your fence, but, you know, one of those things that you can't avoid. Anyways, so let's have a look inside on this level here. This, I guess, is the upper level, technically. Yeah, that's the living level. So up here, we've got a couple of bedrooms, or three bedrooms here. Three single bedrooms right there in the main area. And a bathroom. Is that a bathroom? Yeah, just a bathroom. I thought it was a laundry as well, but it is not. Just a bathroom up the top. And windows looking out over to the ocean. Obviously, windows inside there as well. So if we move down a level now, this is where we get all the sort of main living area, the kitchen, the dining, and the living room here. Well, all three with nice views out over the ocean. Beautiful views through large, big windows looking straight out. Looking pretty, pretty nice. Down one more level, we have the two-car garage. And a way to get up to the next level right there. It's actually just sort of one step high difference, but it's on a different level, and that's how it works. But I think that looks pretty cool nonetheless. Also on this level, we have the master suite right down the bottom of the house, tucked away. I think that's pretty cool. Looking from this angle, it didn't look like Sims could get through, but I think they can get through that area. I presume they tested it. I hope so. But either way, it's a pretty damn cool bedroom right there at the bottom of the house looking out over the ocean. And I thought it was just a really nice design. Also got this big sort of wall coming down the side there, which is kind of interesting as well. Anyways, let's move on. We are now at Ocean Villa by Calistus. I thought this one was just really nice. It's a really, really nice sort of islandy styled house. I thought it looked really quite sweet, actually. And I thought it fit really nicely into this location as well. Anyway, so let's take a look from around the front. Obviously, we got a little car spot over there with a boat trailer and a jet ski on top of it. Let's jump inside now. So the main entrance area is also the main living area, where you have this sort of large kitchen with island counters and sort of centralized sink there, which is really nice. A nice dining table in the center and a living area over there. And what I really do like about this is that the house is like separate buildings. So you have three different buildings. I think that's really cool because it is a tropical place, and I'm sure they wouldn't mind going outside. I mean, the only downside would be when it rains, but anyway, I think that's a really cool idea, sort of having it all separate like that. I thought it was kind of cool anyways. So let's move into this main building over here. Now, what I really did like actually as well was this sort of, this whole area here is like the children's wing. It's not even connected to this other section of the building. Like, you go through this door, this is like a little foyer to their own sort of area. It's like the entrance to their whole section of the house, which is really cool. So you have like two dressers there by the entrance, lots of little toys, sort of all these little details everywhere around the room, little beanbag chairs, areas for all their coats and their shoes, and a door through to their sort of shared bathroom area here. So you got his and her sink, because it's obviously a girl's and a boy's sort of bedroom there. So you got two sinks, and you got your bathtub in there. a little toilet in the next room so they can have a bit of privacy anyways once I go. And then in here is like a really cool shared bedroom, which I thought was actually a really awesome idea. It's one big bedroom, but you got this sort of dividing wall in between. These curtains that you pull over the windows, presumably, because they have a window going through, but you can, or in reality, you'd pull the curtains closed for a bit of privacy now and then. But I thought it was a really, really nice idea. And they've even got their own little private sort of play area out the back. I mean, how sweet is that? If you were a kid, that would be awesome. That would be lit. That is the dream. As a kid, that is the dream. And your own private playground and your own sort of whole section of the house. Well, that's amazing. That is amazingly awesome. Anyways, I'm moving next door now. This is a master bedroom. Absolutely tons of sort of dresses here for all your goods. Really, really fancy as well with all these sort of chandeliers in here. A really large sort of ensuite, really luxurious his and her sinks again. Nice bathtub in there and a separate little bathroom as well for a bit of privacy anyways. And you've got this really nice sort of large window by the bathtub, so you can relax in the bathtub, look out over this little pond here with all those sort of lily pads. I think that's really, really cool. And then the actual bedroom in here, the bed is in the middle, and you've got these panoramic windows around all sides of the room, so there's light coming from every direction. It would be absolutely awesome. Of course, I have their own private balcony out here as well. Look at the new chairs from the Bohemian garden set as well, so that's really cool. So that's really cool over there. Jumping all the way over the other side now. This is quite a long tour of this house. Over the other side of the house now, this is kind of like a guest suite, a guest house, because it's all enclosed by itself. You've got the bedroom and the ensuite sort of bathroom and shower there, and there's a little toilet in that area there, and a sort of little laundry in that section there. So it's kind of like a little guest house. And then this pool as well is pretty damn cool. It's like kind of somewhat an infinity pool. You got all the rocks here on the side, sort of covering it up and sort of blending it in. Large fountain going into the ocean. And I think this is just generally a pretty cool, really islandy kind of feeling place. I thought it was awesome anyways. Here we are at Home Sweet Home on lot number 24. And this one is by Wallan92. Again, I felt this was just a really islandy kind of house up on stilts. You know, that's one of my favorite things, having a house up on stilts. That is your golden ticket to a showcase. No, I'm kidding. But no, I do love the look. And if it's done right, it can be really sweet. And it's really nice how they've sort of blended it in underneath as well. So it looks like it's really sort of part of the terrain. It's like the house has to be on stilts for it to be there. I think that's a really nice touch. So this is obviously the outside we're looking around now. Down the bottom, let's start down the bottom. I've got our car parked underneath. We've got a little, so our garage underneath with a motorcycle in there, lots of workspace here as well. Oopsie daisies, I keep destroying people's houses, sorry about that. And then you've got these stairs going up here. I would turn on the light, but the game doesn't let me, so anyways. Oh wait, no, they stayed on, so that's fine. Anyways, up on the main level now, so you come up the stairs there from the garage, up into the living area here, around the back. Only criticism was this, is it is such a nice island place. But a lot of the windows are covered up by curtains. But I guess in reality, you would have curtains. But the only problem with curtains in The Sims 3 is it actually blocks natural light, which is really annoying. It makes the windows practically useless, which is kind of annoying in The Sims, but that's just how it is. Anyway, so we've got our living room there. Nice sort of kitchen there, which is really quite social and open for everyone to talk and whatever. Around the back here, we've got our little laundry area with our bathroom next to it and a tub in that room there. Is that the master bedroom or is that like a guest bedroom? I can never tell until I look around. Yes, that is the master bedroom, and that is their bathroom coming off it just there. So they got a little separate toilet room and then the tub room and all that, which is nice. That's our floor there. Large deck out the back, of course. Also, the deck and barbecue area down the bottom, which we didn't look at, but there it is. Up on the floor above is where all the single bedrooms are. So we've got that is technically a single bedroom because you can't use it as a double bed because it's blocked off. So yeah, we've got two bedrooms up the top, children's, and I guess they're probably a teenager's bedroom there. And then a study area there, which of course could be turned into a bedroom if you needed it to be. And a secondary living area, which is actually pretty sweet. So you've got two living areas, which is also very, very handy. But yes, that is Home Sweet Home. Here we are at Stylish Starter Plus by Mona Lisa Jones. This is actually a starter home, if you hadn't guessed by the title. And I think that's really awesome. It's $16,129. You can buy it as soon as you start the game. And I think it's a pretty sweet looking lot for just a starter home. That's a really good achievement right there. So if we jump inside now, we got a nice double bedroom, so you can get two Sims in this right away. It's got a really, really nice color scheme going on here too. These really warm, rich colors, these sort of Yellows and browns and a sort of pale blue as well all really go nicely together. And so, yeah, we've got a double bedroom in there, a little bathroom there, our kitchen. Whoa, that's a bit of a weird thing to do, actually. you enter the house right into the kitchen, which is kind of weird. And also what would be annoying as well is that if you're using the fridge and someone comes in the house, it'd smack you in the back of the head. But anyways, I think it probably would have been a better idea to move the kitchen over and or something. But anyways, still, nonetheless, it's still a really, really nice interior, especially for a starter home. Lots of area out the back here on the deck as well. Underneath, you got a ping pong table and a little garden as well, which is really, really sweet. It's sort of, this is the one of the store sets. I can't remember which one it is. Large sort of garden set thing here. All these little plants you can get. So you got little mushrooms and lettuce and grapevines and a lot of stuff going on there. Really vibrant. And it's a starter house, which I think is really, really well done. All right, we've just gone across the street now, and this is Queenslanders Home by Sandra KB. This one I thought was just really nice, actually. It just looked really cool. So if you don't know what a Queenslander home is, it's basically a house, that for one looks like this, and more often than not is raised off the ground by lots of supports like that. So it's like high up off the ground. It's a sort of really quaint styled home. You can Google it, search Queenslander house, and you'll see what it looks like. But anyways, I thought this was a really nice sort of job on one here. So I guess we'll start down the bottom. So right down the bottom is actually, I mean, you wouldn't find this in a regular Queenslander home because they wouldn't be that fancy, but this one is. Got this whole level down the bottom here with an indoor pool. Like, I mean, how fancy do you have to be to have an like, seriously, if you have an indoor pool in reality, that is amazing. Congratulations. I am jealous of having an indoor pool. Like, not many people have those. That is incredible. Anyway, so they've got an indoor pool in this one. And they've even got a little sort of toilet area there and a shower as well. Funny, the shower is outdoor, but all the pool and everything is indoor. But anyways, nice, really nice big pool area down the bottom and outdoor dining around the back with a barbecue and a little pond as well. If we move up onto the main floor, so you enter the house in here, got a really sort of fancy little foyer. Really quaint interior, which suits the styling very nicely. Little sitting area here with no TV, which is fitting as well, because I don't think these guys would have a TV. Around here, we've got the kitchen and dining area and a little bathroom, of course. Oh, two sinks as well. Moving up, we have a nice large landing area, and we have a bathroom off the foyer. The main bedroom in there, nice large double bed, and two single bedrooms with two beds each. So you could have, I guess, up to six Sims in this house as it is. And that's obviously all in that sort of little level up the top there. And I think it's a really, really nice looking house. I thought it was awesome. Anyways, that's Queenslander's home. Here we are at Bayside Retreat by Copacinator. Anyways, moving on. I'm going to say Capacinator. Yeah, so this one is just a really nice sort of modern sort of beach style home. It does have that really beachy vibe, but it's not the classic beach vibe. It's a modern feel to it, which I think is really cool. And it's achieved really, really nicely. So it's done this lot here. It actually extends way out into the ocean, probably the same distance as the one next door, which we'll look at in a moment. So you've got a lot of space for expansion out there if you need it. But let's also have a jump inside of the lot now. It's all sort of suspended above the ground. So underneath, we just got these nice walls and sort of outdoor living area here. A little bar down the bottom, a little pond around the back as well. Lots of space underneath, which is really, really nice, I think. I think it just looks really nice. Got these nice raked sand, little garden flower bed things there. On the main level of the house, we enter through this little walkway here, which I think is really cool, into the main living area with a little kitchen there. A sort of small living area. Obviously, it's not a ginormous house, but it's all in there. Everything you need. A little study area. Nice deck out the back with a barbecue. Two lounge chairs. Around the back, we have the bedroom. It's all sort of open plan as well, which you'll notice, like, the bedroom is part of the main house, which I think is really nice, especially in, like, a beach place. And because it's a modern house and really light, it's really airy as well, all open and really, really free-flowing, which I thought was cool. So you got this sort of nice walk-in wardrobe there and then the bathroom at the back of the house. But, yeah, that is a Bayside Retreat. Really nice sort of modern beachy vibe house, which I thought was awesome. Right, here we are next door on Beachside, a lot by SeaWorldXDD, pronounced just like that. anyways, yeah, so this is like a nice big sort of family home, still got that beachy vibe as well, but it's not the modern beachy vibe, obviously, it's a different beach vibe. And it fits really, really nicely. It's got that really nice green color, the greens and the browns, and like fits in with the terrain. and landscaping really quite nicely. And it's got this massive deck area out the back, which I think is really, really awesome. Like, that should be really cool to have. They have their own private jetty, lots of seating out the back, and a large deck on the upper level as well. Let's jump inside now, down on the bottom level. A chock full garage in here. You got your car, lots of little details in here as well. To sort of do all your sort of mechanical work everywhere you need to. In the entrance of the house here, you just come through, nice big open area. This is all open. You got your living area around this side here. Let me just rotate around. Lots of little details all over the place. Very, very nautical feeling as well. Got your dining table there. Quite a small dining table, but I guess you don't really need a big dining table, especially not The Sims. What is going on there? That is like glitching. Oh, there's that's like supposed to be on the wall, but for some reason, when it loaded, it had them off the wall. There you go. That makes more sense. Anyways, I've got the kitchen in here. Lots of little details in here as well. Looking very, very nice. A laundry / bathroom in the middle there. And then around this room is sort of, I guess, the entertainment room. I guess you got a large pool table and little cushions and seating over there, display cabinet, and large entertaining area out the back, which I think is sweet. It's actually kind of cool what they've done here, and I've only just noticed this, is that you got like the main house sort of balcony here, and it's like they've at some point they've sort of extended their balcony and they've like tacked on this part, which I think is really cool. I've destroyed part of the house. Anyways, up on the sort of upper level where all the bedrooms are, we come up this double wide staircase here. Gets a little unsafe near the top here because you could fall over that wall there. Could use a little fence there, but nevertheless, we've got a nice sort of study area right up the top of the stairs there. A bathroom in the middle. Double bedroom there. A nursery across from the main bedroom. And then a rebellious teens room by the looks of it. So it's looking quite nice. And a nice large balcony up the top as well for that nice beachy vibe. Here we are at The Edge by Tech Mania Alex on lot number 9. We've had quite a few on lot number 9 today, but that's all right. It's another one that goes straight out over the cliff. That is a boat glitch that always happens when you place lots with boats, so let's just put it back down. It's just a really cool design. It's quite a simple design, just a little parallelogram, but it comes out over the cliff, and I thought it looked pretty damn awesome. You got this also this really nice infinity pool over here that has those sort of windows as well. That would be really awesome to see out there. I thought that looked really cool, having that sort of pool and a nice large deck area as well. No shortage of outdoor spaces here at all. And the house just looked really cool because it has all this greenery on the roof as well, nicely arranged and looking quite good. Nice, pretty simple landscaping here and there, but I think it complements the build quite nicely because it's quite a simple shape. But it's quite different and quite unique as well in that sort of respect. Let's jump on to the inside. Now, we've got these large windows that pretty much run down this entire side of the house and wrap around the main living area, which I, again, thought was amazing. There's so much light and so airy and all that. It's quite a few, it's not quite, it's somewhat a futuristic style build in some places. And I say that mainly because you've got this sort of pink light going on over here, or this magenta colored light. Not quite sure what the reason behind that is or if that was even meant to be like that, but it's there. Anyways, let's jump over. So you come in the entrance here and you got a little laundry area there, a little seat, and you got sort of first single bedroom through that door just there. And then you got this sort of little study / office / whatever you want it to be. Little sort of changing room around that side as well, in case you need to change in the office for whatever reason. Continuing down the hallway, you have the sort of main master bedroom in here. Nice large double bed and a sort of table going over the end for a little bit of detailing. Paintings all over the wall and quite an odd sort of emerald coloured statue, which I have never actually done in the game before. So that's quite interesting. Nice easel there on the corner and the ensuite bathroom with little to no privacy. A lot of people seem to like doing that. There's also a shower there, but there's no actual shower in that corner, which is interesting. Not hard to add though, of course. Then around the back, we have this nice kitchen, dining, living area, which I thought was really nice. I thought this was really nice because of the shape. It's this large wedge shape in the corner. And has windows around every single side, which I thought was really, really nice. That's what drew me to this, mainly because it comes out over the cliff, has this awesome shape going to it, and windows everywhere. It just looks awesome. I keep saying awesome on a lot of things today, but it is really, really cool. Anyways, I enjoy this lot, and that is The Edge. Here we are on Driftwood by TJ Duher. Interesting name. Anyways, this is just a large sort of beach house. I thought I had it, like, it's quite big, but I felt like it had sort of, like, it just feels like a big sort of beach kind of hall or sort of something, I don't know, hall, shack or something that was converted into a house. Anyway, that's the kind of vibe I get from it. Probably not what was intended, but I don't know. That's what I felt about it. And I thought it was really nice. It's really well done and really quite well detailed as well. I really like this boat ramp they got going on here. So it's like in real life, obviously you'd have boat ramps that go into the water. You back your boat off, you put the trailer in the water and the boat would sort of flow into the ocean, which I thought was a really nice touch there. Nice little jetty out the back as well. And that's generally the outside of the house. Let's just jump down to the lower floor. So obviously in this area here, we got the car and the boat on the trailer and a few sort of skill building objects here on the side. So we got sculpting and a bit of, is that metalwork or something? I can't remember. I don't even know. Can't remember. Barely use those items. I probably should use ambitions a little bit more. Anyway, in the main house, our main entrance is here on the side. So we come into this sort of foyer area here, this nice little hallway. And off to the right into this sort of living area. We've obviously got the living area with the fireplace and the kitchen there. Nice, quite a large kitchen as well. Small dining area, but quite a large sunroom right at the back here, which I thought was really nice. That definitely gives it a sort of beachy kind of feel. A nice long sunroom at the back. Lots of lounges. You've got the chess table. You've got the easel for a nice painting out over the urchin. Really cool look. A little barbecue out the back and a nice little decking. Oh, not decking. Little seating area out the back there. Moving over to the other side of the house, we have a nice double bedroom there and a nice kid's bedroom over there. Bright green carpet. Lots of little details here and there just to finish it off. And a nice bathroom in the center. On the level above, we have a nice large landing area where the TV is situated. And we have another sort of kid's area. It's like a kid's playroom. Oh, that's cool. Just noticed that's actually a ladder that goes up to that room. Oh, that is awesome. Damn, I would love to be a kid that lived in this island, because some of these lots have the most amazing kids areas. Like, that's really cool. Little window out there. That is cool. I like that. Nice job. And then you got a small bathroom up the top, a couple of arcade machines. Jesus, that'd be amazing to have in your house. And then this is kind of cool because of the way the house is done. So that's like the area above the garage. I thought it was kind of cool. Just have this little hallway connecting it across into this sort of master suite area where you have the nice double bed and the ensuite bathroom and their own little balcony out the front too. And one thing to just cap it off was they did my little logo up in the roof. That made me laugh when I saw it, and I thought that was quite funny. So that's this lot here, Driftwood. And we're back over on lot number one. This is Island Vista by Amber Blair. 81. A nice large sort of estate kind of house. Again, there's quite a few I've shown for lot number one lately, but it's quite nice. It's got that nice lighthouse over there, but that's not what we're here to look at. Large sort of, paved area out the front, obviously where you drive your cars in reality. I guess we'll have a look at the outside first before we jump inside. Nice large lake off to that side. We've got a nice big pool area as well. A trampoline out back, little alfresco area, alfresco area there with a little bar, which the texture hasn't loaded for yet. Slowly, I look little day bed kind of things. Anyways, that's not loading too quickly, but so we've got a trampoline out the back, lots of grass area, a nice area under the tree here, soccer goal right there, and a doghouse, and there's our alfresco dining. And around the back underneath, we've got a nice outdoor sitting area with a large, large fireplace. And it's reflecting super, super blue for some reason. That would just be because of some reflecting glitch. I don't know. It's reflecting something blue, apparently, which is why things look a bit blue. But anyways, you can ignore that. And so we've got the barbecue area there. Nice fountain around that side. Let's go around to the entrance of the house and let's follow with him. So we come in this area here and it opens up in this large open plan living area with a nice sitting area and a TV above the fireplace and a ginormous kitchen. That is a beautiful kitchen. Really love it. You've got the double cookers in the middle. Giant island counter section. Looking awesome. Lots of detailing here inside with all these all these sort of shelving areas there. And if we follow it through into here, we've got a nice large bar area, which is pretty sweet, and a sunken sort of area here, which I presume goes into a garage. Yes, it does. Garage with a boat and a boat trailer, two car spots, and lots of little detailing, sort of little junk bits here and there that they've kind of thrown in the garage. It's awesome. So I quite like this area. It comes off into a laundry and a bathroom just there. Very nicely done. And we jump over to the other side of the house. We've got the sort of TV room through nice large French doors there. Moving into the back of the house is where it sort of breaks up into the bedrooms and the sort of, I guess this is sort of like the parents' retreat area in a way, because they basically have this whole half of the house. So this is like their little foyer. I guess, oh, it's not, Well, I guess it is the parents, all the parents' stuff, but I would have figured they would have put a door there as well. But anyways, I don't know. So that's obviously the main bedroom, and they have like a walk-in robe, and then this is sort of like the, I guess, entrance. It's like a foyer to the bathroom, a little towel area, I guess we'd store your towels, and you got a large bathroom area. Look at that. That's a really cool sort of shower design they've got going on there. They've got like this whole sort of corner area there cut out for the shower, and that's in there. Really, really nicely done. Lots of counters there, a toilet, and I keep destroying people's houses. Raised up tub area there as well. So if we jump upstairs now, we'll see all the other bedrooms. So they come up through this nice sort of U-shaped staircase there. It's looking pretty fancy. Nice large bathroom there, and quite a nicely detailed bedroom there, as well as all the others along this way. All really nicely done as well. All quite large bedrooms as well. It's not a small house. Plenty of room. This is an upstairs living area with a nice ginormous TV. And you got a ping pong table. You got foosball. You got your arcade machines. And you got a spiral staircase, which I didn't notice before, but there it is, leading straight up into that room there that you can get quick access to. And another full on double bedroom there with an ensuite. So there's no shortage of space for Sims in this house. And it is definitely quite a nice little house. I say little. It's quite a nice large house that you can chuck into your world. Here we are at Thunder 38 on lot number 9. This one is by the Matteo Zero, or however you want to say it. And it's quite a nice, I don't know what's going on at the moment, but we're getting a lot of weird blue reflections. I don't know. I guess there's probably something, maybe it's something to do with the world that I could fix. I don't know. Something to note down for me to look into later. It seems to be reflecting blue quite a lot. Anyways, built on this cliff lot right here. And I thought it was just a really nice sort of cascading lot that fit on this lot quite nicely. And it's again, someone else has done this as well. You got this pool out here in this sort of cantilevered area. I don't know, maybe that's like some sort of fad that I'm not aware of. And they've got two pools as well. They've got a pool there and a pool up there and then the ocean. Anyways, let's jump into the house. Let us not delay. So if we go to the entrance level, which would be this one here, we come up to this main sort of deck and walk in our large doors to a nice pool table, grand piano, and a little sitting area there. Nice big deck area out the back as well. Lots of space. No shortage of space out the back and a nice hot tub there. If we move downstairs through these stairs, we come down to the kitchen dining area here. Nice large kitchen and quite a lot of seats at the dining table. Through two large archways which lead into sort of a couple of bedroom or one bedroom here and then sort of the more outdoor space. So you got a nice large bathroom, a little karaoke station there, a very unsafe staircase. You'd probably want to put fences there at some point. But yeah, so you got a large bedroom there and a nice little foyer that leads outside to more deck area. There's no shortage of deck space on this lot at all. So we got all of that space right in there. And then if we move down again on another level, down the bottom here, we come into this another little sitting area down here, which leads into a, you got a double bedroom just in there, along with a nice bathroom right next door to it. Around the side here, we've got a nice large gym area, a nice home gym around the back, and a really nice sort of study area here with lots of books and a nice desk in the center. Around the other side, we've got another sitting area. This one has the TV. I don't think the other ones had any TVs. In the back here, we've got like a sauna area. Nice relaxing place. And another little sort of study slash home office kind of room right there. And then there's nothing below that. So anyways, and then outside, of course, we've got a pool there, lots of sort of lounge chairs all around the place. And we've got another pool up here, which I guess would offer some awesome views. But I don't know how safe that is. Down the bottom, we've obviously got a boat and it's very nicely landscaped throughout the lot as well. Here we are on Mint Condition by Wheezy99. Now, I thought this one was actually really cool. It just has a kind of nice sort of roof flow going on here, and it looks cool. And it just a really nice sort of cliff lot as well. Something different, looks kind of cool. That's what I love about all these lots. There's so many different ways that people have built in this world. It's absolutely amazing. It's so awesome to see how many different ideas people come up for on the same lot. Like the number of ways that you guys can build on the same lot is incredible. It's so awesome to see. Anyways, outside we obviously have a car with a little carport there. Nice little pond and a little bit of landscaping around the place. Looking quite fancy. Let's just jump down onto the main level here. Come up onto the deck with a couple of lounge chairs there. Looking quite nice and mint with a little bit of lemonade going on there. You enter the house into this little foyer, which opens up into our kitchen and dining area. Got the mismatched chairs going on. Obviously, a bit of a Deligracy inspiration going on in here. And a beautiful living area here with large, large windows looking out over the ocean like that. How incredible would it be to live in a house like this? And if you do, and you're watching this video, if you live in a house that has these kind of views over the ocean, that is, I don't know, I keep saying this, but that is amazing. That would be so beautiful to look out your window and see. Anyways, yeah, so we've got a really nicely detailed sort of living area in here. Around the side here, what have we got? We've got a little study area with a bookcase and a couple of seats in there to get your skill building up, and a little bathroom down on the lower floor here. Moving upstairs now, we have a small little landing area here with a little bookcase kind of thing there, a little sofa. Oh, that's cool. It's like an open plan sort of master bedroom, which I guess wouldn't provide a lot of privacy considering it has a second bedroom, but I guess that's not the point. So it's nice like open plans that have upper area, which is kind of cool. I guess this is technically an ensuite then. And then I guess that bedroom here is technically an ensuite of that bedroom, if that makes any sense. Yeah, anyway, so we have two bedrooms and then the bathroom up here. And it's just, and this bedroom around the back here has incredible views. I kind of feel sorry for the sort of master bedroom because they just have views out the side looking onto another house. Not quite as luxurious as this bedroom here, but it is still a very nice little lot. Here we are at Sands Beach Club. This one is by Slive Dog. Sorry, I was about to say Silver Dog. It says Slive Dog. This is just a really cool little community lot, which I thought was quite awesome. Got all these little, I really like all the little beach huts going on here. It's actually really cool. Nice little idea. So if you jump inside, there's not too much. A little bit going on here. A little sort of little counter area here. And you got your music speakers all around the place as well. A little bar. Upstairs, what do we have? We have a couple of public bathrooms there. And then through all these, we have sort of little areas you can go get a bit of food, have a shower, you know, like your changing room type of places anyways, is I guess it's what it's aimed to be. But it's just a really nice sort of hangout community lot. And then around the other side, of course, you've got a nice little public pool, lots of parking spots for everybody coming to the beach. It's just a nice little beach lot, really. And I thought it was a really nice way to sort of finish it off, really. Nice little community lot. I will be probably doing a community lot specific showcase. There's so many lots for the main park as well that I haven't done yet, and I've specifically avoided them just because I want to wait and just do like a whole video just on parks, because there is so many parks to choose from, and there's some amazing festival lots too that you guys have done. It's really awesome. I'll probably do a community lot showcase and do a bunch of those. So if you haven't done a community lot, get building, because you might be in the next video. But that's it for this time, guys. Thank you for watching the showcase. Some awesome lots here by some amazing creators. All the links to the houses I showcased are in the description down below, so you can check it out there. And thanks for watching. I'll see you next time, and have an awesome day.